When renovating, nothing usually goes as planned. At the beginning of the year, we thought that by the time summer arrived, we would have already finished our own bedroom. But in reality, we are far from that. This bedroom is much more work than we anticipated, and I'm glad we didn't start with it as our first room to renovate. Because otherwise, I think our courage would have quickly sunk into our shoes. It's more work than the other rooms, especially since we stripped all the walls bare, down to the bricks. And all the walls must be plastered again. And that's what we are doing now. Plastering the walls.
Je blijft dat tegen de muur drukken. En dan doe je hem langzaam.
Oh, dat is best wel wat kracht hoor.
Ja, dat is het. Zo. Maar ja, het zat natuurlijk aan de andere kant niet.
Ja, zo is het. Ja. Zie je?
Oké. Moet je het dan proberen. Ja, als je veel wil. Zo'n beeld op. Dat doe je niet.
Dat is geen plat dus. Nou, dan zit hij precies in geul, dus dan is dat niet handig. En die nat genoeg wellicht. Niet nat genoeg meer. Maar dat ook, dat is niet nog goed pakt.
Klopt het niet zo.
Every week I drive a lot around the surroundings of our village, often taking the same route to get Fleur to gymnastics. But it's never getting boring. This time we drove to a small village where there was a vide-grenier, literally meaning empty your attic. That's exactly what people do there. They sell unwanted items. to give them a second life again. Or a third one, maybe. It was a very small one, and I didn't buy anything except some waffles for Jules. However, the village itself is very pretty and has a small museum that you can visit for free, where you can see the history of the village through some old pictures.
Merci.
Merci.
Thanks, by the way, for all the lovely comments on our 18-month renovation video. Sometimes I think we haven't done much. Many things we've started aren't completely finished like I wanted them to be. But while making that video, I realized that we accomplished much more than I thought. And it's not just only the renovation of our house during that time. We also managed to start a whole new life. Moving to another country is much more than just relocating to another house in the same country where you lived your whole life. When we moved to France, we started from zero again. It wasn't just moving into an old house that needed to be renovated into our dream home. We also had to learn the French language, which involves constantly translating in your mind. You're always a step behind the person speaking to you. They've already started their second sentence while you're still translating the first one in your head. We had to find new French, which isn't easy when you don't speak the language well at first. Just getting used to our new environment took a lot of energy too. A trip to the grocery store during the first few months required a lot of effort, searching for new products, figuring out where to find them in the store, and learning their French names. But now, after living here for just 2 years, things are getting easier each day. Many aspects of life are becoming more familiar, and tasks take less energy than they did initially. Our French is improving, but the language still requires a lot of effort every day. But we love being part of the French community, adopting their language and culture. This is the country we fell in love with 11 years ago, and each day we are falling more in love with it. We are so grateful to be allowed to live here.